Hi. So if you found this video, I assume you probably already know what MidiQuest is. I put this video together mainly because there are so few videos on YouTube about MidiQuest, and hopefully this will help some of you get up and running. I'll also show you a hack that will let you get into and actually edit and view the parameters for any template that MidiQuest makes. If you look in the help file, and you go down to the panel edit section, then scroll down just a slight bit, you'll see this disturbing bit of text. It says, with MidiQuest XL, you have full access to all parameters for any editor that you create. But then it says that for all the versions of MidiQuest, you can only access a subset of parameters. So what this means is, by default, the templates, all the instruments that they make, they let you use, but they don't let you edit them, and they don't let you see how they're put together. And what a shame, what a waste when it comes to an excellent learning resource. So I've actually figured out how to, if you are at all familiar with using a hex editor, one tiny, tiny change will let you get into that file and unlock the restriction that they have on there by default. Okay, so let's get started. I'll start pretty much from scratch in terms of the process. Oops, not text me. Okay, here we go. So if you go up to Studio in MidiQuest and you go to Install Instrument, in my case from disk because I got all the instruments downloaded from the website, choose the folder that they're in. Okay, it doesn't really matter what synthesizer you pick here. Obviously, you'll be picking one that you have, probably. So let's just go for the Virus C for this example. Okay, click OK. I don't have MIDI hooked up right now, so I'm going to get that message. Okay, and I just want to make a new patch bank, yes. Alright, I'll move this out of the way now. I think we're pretty much done with that. Okay, and so now let's say we want to make a new single in bank A, yes, define it. Alright, so here's our new patch. Now, if we were just a passive user of the program and we wanted to make we wanted to make music using this patch, then we certainly could. But when I first used MidiQuest, my main interest was being able to customize and make my own interface to my synthesizer. And so, I was trying to get in there and figure out how to edit it. So what you do, first of all, you can't get to the editing window from here. It's a rather horrible interface. You've got to go back. You've got to go back to your singles bank, right-click on the patch, go to the Edit menu, and then click Editor Window. Okay. Now, you might think, okay, this is the editor window, I can edit the thing from here. Not yet. You still can't edit it yet. You've got to go up to the Editor menu and go down to Panel Edit. Okay, it warns you that you're modifying the layout and that most of your tools are going to be found in the right-click menu, which is true. Alright, so here we are. Looks great. Looks like we'll be able to get in here, make any sort of changes we want to. I spent hours and hours trying to figure out why things were not working like I thought they should be. Let's look at a couple of things that you can do with it. Okay, you can move things around by default. By the way, I'm holding the Command key and dragging this item in order to move it around. The interface is really slow on the Mac. I can move things around. I can, what can I do? If I double-click on an empty area here, I will get only two items that I can create. You'll see in just a few minutes that this is a huge restriction compared to what's available, but we'll unlock that in a moment. I can create new tags, new bitmaps. In terms of parameters, if you click on a control, you can see basic things like the size and what sort of skinning it's using or things like that, having to do with aesthetic types of things. But it doesn't tell you, it doesn't let you edit or see how the underlying code is written. It doesn't let you see what messages are being sent to your device. Okay, so that's enough of this default mode. As you can see, it's rather restricted. One other thing that you can't do with it, just briefly, is you can't change the type of control this is. If I think this should be a slider, I can't change it. I want to copy and paste. No copy. Paste is only there because I've got something else from a previous session, but copy is not available. Normally, paste wouldn't be available either if you hadn't copied something. So, yeah, all the most useful things in terms of creating, in terms of learning, they're all disabled. So I'm going to show you right now how you can get in there and edit that template file. So first let's close it. No, we don't need to save it. All right. So first of all, you're going to want to navigate to a particular folder, which I'll show you right now. So you're going to want to navigate to your computer, library, application support, SoundQuest, MidiQuest XL, and inside of that you'll have the instruments folder. And inside of the instruments folder you'll see folders and a few files for all the instruments that you have defined, that you've added to your studio, either now or in the past. So we just added Virus C, so now we have this folder here. If we open it up, we'll see a lot of different files in here. The ones that we're interested in are files that end in .sqt. So the patch editing template that we were just looking at, that we were just using, that's this file right here, patch.sqt. So that's the file that we want to actually get into the hex editor and make our little change on. All right. So I'm using this Hex Fiend program. I think it's, I'm pretty sure it's a free program. If you're on the Mac, you can use it. Otherwise, there are plenty out there for the PC. Just drag the file onto it. All right, so here's the file. So what we're interested in, it's a lot of junk here, but the only thing we're interested in is byte number 21. Okay. Currently, byte number 21 is a 1. This is just a flag saying, don't let people edit this file. All we need to do is just change this to a 0, save it, and we're done. Very, very, very simple, but it took tons of just hit and miss attempts to finally find that one byte. All right, so if we go back in here, and once again, we right-click, go to Edit, go to the Editor window, just like we did a while ago. Notice we didn't have to quit. It just it loads it up every time from that file on the fly. Let's see here. Panel Edit. Get the same dialog box. Okay, now here's the good stuff right here. So number one, we double-click on this blank area. Look at all these things we can make in here. We click on a control. Can we copy it? Yes, we can copy it now. Looking over on the right, there are some newly added fields that weren't here before. The most important ones being default W, Y, and Z. Those are variables. The macro that is being sent to your hardware when, the macro is actually executed internally, but the low-level code, such as this MW equals 54, is sent to the synthesizer. You can view all of the macros that are used in this file, which you could not do before. I know I didn't show that. So here's macro 0. You couldn't get at this before. You couldn't see how it's all put together. You'll notice that a lot of these, well, there are actually quite a few used on this particular template, but there are a lot available. Oops, there was one here. There's another one. There are a lot available that are not used. So again, you're free to experiment on your own. If I'd like to convert this into a slider, for example, I can now copy it, which I did while ago, but I'll do it again. Copy. So let's custom paste it. Let's see, sometimes it's kind of picky about which one you choose. I'm going to do a slider. I'll try this. Before I did slider bitmap, this time I'll try slider graphic. Maybe that's the one. There we go. That's what I meant to choose a while ago. Okay, now of course it looks terrible, so we can just change the height to, 150, and that should make it much, much clearer.